At the Board of Selectmen meeting this past week, Lycan Bioscience, LLC, updated the selectmen on their interest in moving to Hopkinton.
My name is Lynn Tokarczyk. I'm Government Incentives Consultant representing Lycan Bioscience. I'm here with Tony Rotuno, CEO of Lycan Bioscience, and David Dartel, right in back of me, CFO of Lycan Bioscience.
Lycan Bioscience is an emerging manufacturer of cell and gene therapies, very new generation of therapeutics. So new that there's only four approved currently, but gaining a lot of traction, and it's the next generation of therapeutics over and above beyond what we've seen before from biologics. Company plans to lead the way in manufacturing clinical products out of the Hopkinton site for immunotherapies of cancer and other illnesses. I will say that our sole focus right now is oncology. That's where the greatest need is. That's where we see the greatest need, so that's where we'll focus. Immunotherapy is on a cutting edge of treatments that are less invasive than traditional cancer therapies, and they offer a promise of greater patient safety. This is personalized medicine for the most part, so we're using patient cells, patient's blood, treat the blood at what would be the Hopkinton site, send back the patient very quickly with very little inventory or zero inventory, and then reinfuse the reinjected back into the patient, lights the patient's own immune system up to whatever cancer they're fighting, breast, colon, lung, whatever the case may be. So the safety profiles are very good. Lycan Bioscience plans to choose locations for its clinical manufacturing operations, which we have chosen, and we've chosen Hopkinton. Specifically at this point in time, 97 South Street facility. We've conducted searches in and out of the state, primarily in Arizona and South Carolina to this point. I will say that we've done a national search. We've ended up with a small bucket of sites that really fit the bill. One being that why would we choose Hopkinton? Because access to airports is critical, so we have Logan, and we have TF Green, and we have Worcester. Why? Because the patients, you know, we had the opportunity to work on the first approved product. So we have 6 years of experience with the first cell therapy approved for prostate cancer called Provenge. It was approved in 2010. Since there's been two more. But very quick time frame back to the patient. In the case of Provenge, it was only 18 hours once manufacturing was complete. Back to the patient, wherever they were in the country. Mm-hmm. We did 85% of our production out of a site south of Atlanta. And those products, we did 80% of production out of Atlanta. We had a site in Seal Beach, California also. They took mainly California. But we could have distributed 95% of our products, even with an 18-hour time frame. So access to airports are critical. The access to talent in Massachusetts, obviously. And we have a lot of built-in customers right here in the Cambridge Metro West area. So
a TIF does not apply to the existing building or the taxes that the town is currently receiving. Again, it's only on the new taxes. And it's a minimum of 5 years, a maximum of 20 years for any particular length of a TIF, as you may know, in a minimum exemption of 1%. And the maximum is 100%. So the town is in the position, based on that capital expenditure of approximately $10 million and whatever the assessed value is determined to be, the new assessed value, to collect new tax revenue over a period of time. So again, it's very important that it's to say, again, that it's a discount only on projected future taxes, and there is no loss to the community.
How about biohazard classifications on site, anything like that, that our fire department...
The biohazard, be all BL1, BL2. I mean, these products are taken right in the... most of the patients, you get their blood drawn right in the Red Cross or any common area in any hospital. So
nothing extreme or...
No, and even the vaccines, whatever we use, whatever we need to do, whatever antigens we're using will not be... but nothing above a BL2 for sure, likely all BL1. All of our waste, because again, it's compact, will all be carted away.
The board also unanimously approved a trail coordination management committee.
The Trails Coordination and Management Committee shall consist of seven members who are Hopkinton residents and appointed by the Board of Selectmen. Initial members shall be appointed to 1, 2, and 3-year terms to achieve staggered terms, and all members appointed thereafter will serve 3-year terms. No member may serve more than 3 consecutive terms. The membership shall be as follows. 4 members at large. 1 member who is recommended by the Parks and Recreation Commission. 1 member who is recommended by the Conservation Commission, and 1 member who is recommended by the Planning Board. Committees, organizations recommending members may recommend more than one for consideration, and those recommended need not be members of the recommending body. All members shall have a demonstrated interest in the development, management, and use of public trails. 1 member or associate member who also has expertise in facilitation and communication is desirable. The Board of Selectmen may appoint up to 5 associate, those would be non-voting members if desired, in order to broaden the perspective, representation, or to facilitate the charge of the committee. No associate members shall be appointed until 1 year after a quorum of full members has been appointed, so as to allow for time for the committee to fully consider and clarify its purpose and charge.